गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, आर टुडेज टॉपिक इज इवन एंड ओड नंबर्स। यू हैव रीड अबाउट दिस एंड सॉल्व द सम्स अकॉर्डिंग टू इवन एंड ओड नंबर इन योर क्लास टू ऑल्सो। सो वंस अगेन आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू वट इज ओड नंबर एंड वट आर इवन नंबर्स। Odd numbers. The number 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9, they are called odd numbers because they do not make perfect pairs of 2. So they are called odd numbers. How? With one example, I will clear this. Suppose number 5. Here are 5 circles, 3, 4, 5, and we are making the group of 2. So these 2 I make one group, with these 2 I make one more group. So have you seen here that 2 groups are prepared and 1 circle is left. So it means 5 number is not making proper group. That's why it is called odd number. Some more example. The number which is not divisible by 2, that number is also called odd number. Means the number which is divisible by 2, but it leaving the remainder as a 1. So if we divide 9 by 2, 2 for the 8 and 1 is left as a remainder. So the number which is not divisible by 2, which is not properly divisible by 2, when it is divided by 2, it gives 1 as a remainder. These type of numbers are called odd numbers. So how many these type of numbers which are not divisible by 2 and not exactly divisible by 2? These numbers are 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. So any number, suppose it is 2001, and we have to check it, either it is an odd number or even number. How can we check? We will check only its ones place digit. Its ones place digit, it is not divisible by 2. If we trying to divide it by 2, it is not exactly divisible. That's why this number is called odd number. So it means this 2001 is a odd number. Few more example. 11. We have to check 11 is an even number or odd number. How we will check? Either you will try to make its group. Suppose we are making group of 2, 2, 11 things are here, 11 triangles are here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. Now we are making the group of 2. So one group, one more group made here. These two things are also making a group. Here also, these two also, but one triangle left. It means number 11 is not making proper pairs, is not making proper group. That's why this type of numbers are called odd numbers. So I think this is clear to you. Odd number, one more. You can read from here also. If a number has 1, 3, 7 or 9 in its ones place, it is called odd number. See the example how? 11, its ones place digit is 1, so it is odd number. 23, its ones place digit is 3, so it is also odd number. 35, ones place digit is 5, odd number. Same with the other number. 111, its ones place digit is 1. 1 is a odd number. 97, ones place digit is 7. And 7 is a odd number. So, the number which ends with 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9, these are called odd numbers. This is their first definition. Their second definition is the number which not making proper group, not making complete pair or groups are also called odd number. These are also called odd numbers. Okay. Third one, the given number, if we divide by 2 and it doesn't exactly divisible and it leaves 1 as a remainder, it leaves 1 as remainder. So that those numbers are called odd numbers. Clear? So with these three definitions, we can define odd numbers. So I'm giving you some questions. You will tell me either it is odd number or not. 201, 319, 560, 313, 317, 315. I told you we will check only the ones place digit. Ones place digit is 1, so it become odd number. For odd, we will use O as a symbol. Ones place digit is 9, yes, it also become odd. 0, no, it is not a odd number, no, because ones place digit should be 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9, only then it is odd number, otherwise not. Last is 3, yes, it is odd number. Last digit, ones place digit 7, yes, odd number. Ones place digit 5, yes, it is also odd number. Clear? Next is even numbers. What are even numbers? If a number has 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8 in ones place, it is called even number. Or second definition of this, this is first definition. Second is, if the given number is exactly divisible by 2 and leaving 0 as a remainder, so that number is even number. 2 6 is 12. If we divide 12 by 2, 2 6 is 12. Remainder is 0. So 12 is a even number, because when we divide this number by 2, it gives 0 as a remainder. Third definition, if we make the pair, if the given number makes the proper pairs, 1, here are 12 cross, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And I am making the group of 2, 2. So one group, one more group, so here 12 number is making proper pairs, that's why it is no other object is left, no other value is left, that's why it is called even number. Clear? So with three definitions I have cleared you. First one is the last digit, ones place digits should be 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. It means the digits should be whole number, and those whole numbers will be 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8. Second rule, the number should be divided by 2 and remainder should be 0. Third is, the number makes perfect pairs. No object left, no digit left. Clear? So now I will give you a few examples, few questions I will explain. First is, 1230, 3486, 1080. Firstly, we have to check these are even number or not. Even number condition is the ones place digit should be either 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. So see, the ones place digit is 0, so yes, it is even number, and we have used for even number symbol E. 6, ones place digit is 6, yes, it is a even number. Ones place digit is 0, again it is a even number. Now 2335, 2338. Ones place digit is 5. Is it even number? No. It is. Which type of number is this? Odd number. Is this even number? Yes. So for even number we will write E. A few more examples in front of you. There are some rules regarding even and odd numbers. First rule is, the sum of two odd number is an even number. If we add two odd numbers, their sum will be even number. Why it is even number? Because its ones place digit is 4. Second, if we add two even numbers, 16 is an even number because its ones place digit is 6. 18 is also an even number, ones place digit is 8. When we add it, it becomes 34. And 34's ones place digit is also even number. 34 is also an even number. So when we add two even numbers, we get sum as a even number. Third property is, third rule regarding even and odd numbers, the sum of an odd number and a even number is an odd number. Means if we add odd number and even number, then their sum is, here sum is 27, and 27 is a odd number. So it means when we add odd number and even number, their sum will be odd number. Clear? What was the rule? Odd numbers, their sum will be even number. odd number plus odd number sum will be even. Second, even number plus even number, their sum will also be even number. How? 10 plus 12, both are even number, sum is 22, and 22 is a even number. Odd number sum, 15 is a odd number, 13 is a odd number, their sum is 28. So odd plus odd, their sum is even. Clear? So now in this way you can do exercise 1F. It is based on odd and even number. In your exercise there is question 2, the greatest 3 digit odd number. For doing this, first of all you have to think that greatest 1 digit number is 9, 2 digit greatest number is 99, and 3 digit greatest number is 999, and 999 is a odd number because its ones place digit is 9. So our answer of this question 2 is the greatest 3 digit odd number is 999. This question 3 here, the smallest odd number. Smallest odd number is 1. And before 1, no number is there. In natural number, no number is there. So smallest number is 1 and it is a odd number also. Question 4. The greatest 2 digit number. Firstly write greatest 2 digit number. Then question is the greatest 2 digit even number. This is odd number. So it's before counting 98, it is a even number. So the right answer here, greatest 2 digit number, and it should be even, so it is 98. If I will write 99, then it become odd number. Question 5, the greatest 4 digit even number. Greatest 4 digit number is 9999, but it is odd number. We have to find out even number. So even number kya hoga? 9998. 9992 is also even number, but in this greatest even number is 9998. Clear? Okay. Your today's task is you have to do the practice of odd and even number. If any doubt, you can ask to your parents also, otherwise in next class I will discuss you. If there is any query, if you will send through message that ma'am this concept is still not clear, then I will help you out. Thank you. Have a nice day.